apologies to those of you who are just joining us online. And I just said, you'll catch up with the gospel when you hear it, so I won't reiterate that. I've just said that you will notice that my position this morning has been usurped momentarily by Ian. Just to preempt a little bit, Ian's going to talk to us about his health. I had actually rung him, that's why I was standing outside a few minutes ago, just to check that, to say to him that I understood that perhaps this morning, that contrary to what he'd hoped, he wouldn't be feeling so good. So I would speak for him and reiterate the conversation that he and I have had recently. Not to be daunted, here is Ian, and as we listen, we remember that promise of Christ that his spirit will always be with us. Ian, can I invite you to remain seated? Is that right? Just for my nerves.
This is not about me, it's about prayer. As you all know, for years my health has been poor. I'm going to hospital, a lot of people go to lunch. On Monday night in bed, I experienced alternate night and fertility, terrible pain. I mean, I've had pain in my life. I prayed to die, and that prayer wasn't answered. I became very angry with the Lord. I said, well, I've held you many times, Lord. I'm better to meet you now. But I'm not paying, thank you very much. It's got the pain. Well, blessings that happened. On the Tuesday morning, I had my weekly appointment with Stapler. Unfortunately, I was so ill, my daughters had to take me, literally carry me there. My breathing was disastrous. My heart, I saw the nurse I've seen every week for 9 years. Look at her face, I knew I wasn't very well. She said, you must see a doctor. So I went to see a doctor immediately at the clinic. He then said to my daughter, she said, Dad, hurry up. We arranged for me to have Adamowitz. And when he comes out of Adamowitz, I have a place arranged for him in a hospice or care at home. Which, in matter of fact, one of my daughters, one of them had to go back to some college at work, the other one took me to the hospital at Adamowitz. We went to Adamowitz, got to AME. You've all been to AME, had incredible evidence. We got there, they were waiting for me, went to the door. Oh, you haven't got to join the queue, Mr. Heenan. Give this door, the doctor waiting for me. And within half an hour, cut me full of morphine. They tried to tell me that spat on me, so it didn't work. I then put on a trolley, and within 3 hours of being in the Stapler Medical Centre, I was on a ward in the room of my own. I then met a staff nurse, she's called Jackie Prince, an Indian lady. Rest of the day, I took test after test after test. She was with me all the time. Wonderful lady. And eventually about 11 at night, I was back in the ward, back in bed, and she took him dose of the morphine. Next morning, that lady came and said that nurse had never seen again. She said to me, I've been praying for you, but I'm Indian, I'm a Christian. And suddenly, I can't describe the words, the pain went away, and I felt if I've got another chance to do something. She said to me, the Lord said to her, tell him he's got something more to do. I spoke to Alan about this, and we decided that my more to do isn't to help Michelle with the dinners, because they'll be poisoned. I'm not a very good cook. But the most important thing is to say to you, we're all Christians here. We are adverts for Christ. If you see someone in distress, please pray for them. Those prayers are out of this world. I ask you to pray for India each week. Without your prayers, and the prayers of other people, I'm convinced she wouldn't be here. She's been taking a blood support system, she's now in Norwich. She's still, I'm very unwell, but she's still with us. And thank you so much this morning for indulging me. But please, prayer is so, so important. Please do not think it's a little thing, it's a massive, massive thing. And we are here for a fantastic minister. Thank you.
I've just said to him, do you want us to pray for you now? And I said, you are on the list. He said, on the list, it will be fine. But I said, let's do a double dose. So can you join me, please, in praying for our brother Ian? Dear God, we thank you for the presence of Ian amongst us, for his witness of faith. Thank you for Jackie, who prayed for him, for all those others who hold him in love and in prayer. As we hear this morning of the gift of your Spirit, we pray for a strengthening of the life of your Spirit in him, for the courage and hope and the light that that Spirit brings. Lord, we place him in your hands. And we pray for him in all that you have left for him to do, that he would accomplish that with courage and faithfulness. Lord, we ask your blessing on him and on his family. In your precious name we pray. Amen. I'm now going to sing. I had considered changing the opening hymn, but I thought if I changed the day of resurrection, which if that isn't a hymn of faith, I don't know what is, he might punch me. And we wouldn't want to witness that. So let us stand to sing the day of resurrection, Earth Tell It Out Abroad, 216.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Alleluia. Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
So we stand before the living God and we open our whole selves to his life and his love. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Please sit or kneel. In baptism we died with Christ, so that as Christ was raised from the dead, we might walk in newness of life. Let us receive new life in him as we confess our sins in penitence and faith. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with the living bread. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May the God of love and power forgive you and free you from your sins, heal and strengthen you by his Spirit, and raise you to new life in Christ our Lord. Amen. We stand to sing the Gloria. So by his continual presence in us, he may raise us to eternal joy. Through the same Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Would you please be seated as Diane comes to read our first reading.
The reading is taken from Acts 17, 22-31. Then Paul stood in the midst of the Areopagus and said, "Men of Athens, I perceive that in all things you are very religious. For as I was passing through and considering the objects of your worship, I even found an altar with this inscription, "To the unknown God." Therefore, the one whom you worship without knowing, him I proclaim to you. God, who made the world and everything in it, since he is Lord of heaven and earth, and does not dwell in temples made of hands, nor is he worshipped with men's hands, as though he needed anything, since he gives all breath and all things. And he has made from one blood every nation of men to dwell on the face of the earth, and has determined their pre-appointed times and the boundaries of their dwellings, so that they should seek the Lord, in the hope that they might grope for him and find him, though he is not far from each one of us. For in him we live and move and have our being, as also some of your own poets said, "For we are also his offspring." Therefore, since we are the offspring of God, we ought not to think that the divine nature is like gold or silver or stone, something shaped by art and man's devising. Truly, these times of ignorance God overlooked, but now commands all men everywhere to repent, because he has appointed a day on which he will judge the world in righteousness by the man whom he has ordained. He has given assurance of this to all by raising him from the dead. This is the word of the Lord.
The choir in a moment will sing some verses of Psalm 66. Choir, could you just remind me, please, of how many verses you're singing?
7 to the end.
7 to the end, thank you. So Psalm 66, if you wish to follow along, it's on page 353 in these green books. Verses 7 to the end. When we get to the end, we'll stand as we are able and join the choir in singing "Glory Be to the Father."
Thank you.
Alleluia. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Alleluia.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. This is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. You know him, because he abides with you, and he will be in you. I will not leave you orphaned. I am coming to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me. Because I live, you also will live. On that day, you will know that I am in my Father, and you in me, and I in you. They who have my commandments and keep them are those who love me. And those who love me will be loved by my Father. And I will love them and reveal myself to them. This is the gospel of the Lord. And I was delighted and excited to find in the chapel a vast and beautiful mural by Alan Oldfield depicting her revelations of divine love. The risen Christ is at the centre, and in the shadows to the right, Lady Julian at her lectern with her book in hand. I often found myself at the end of a busy and intense day, sitting in the peace and stillness of that chapel, with the vision of her revelations before me, and an awareness of the comforting, strengthening spirit encircling me. It was 650 years ago on May the 8th, 1373, during a very serious illness, that Lady Julian first received 13 remarkable showings or revelations of divine love from God. And on her recovery, she dedicated the rest of her life as an anchoress meditating upon and writing down her mystical experience, and ministering to and praying for all those who sought her out in those turbulent and difficult times. Julian tells her faith story in beautifully descriptive yet simple language and concludes, "And from the time that it was revealed, I desired to know in what was our Lord's meaning. And 15 years after and more, I was answered in spiritual understanding. Know it well. Love was his meaning. Who reveals it to you? Love. What did he reveal to you? Love. Why does he reveal it to you? For love. Remain, abide in this, and you will know more of the same, but you will never know different without end." Her witness beautifully echoes the very essence of today's short yet powerful gospel text. John's gospel was written around about 80 AD and in very tough times. Most of the disciples were no longer alive, and few of the followers of the way would have been in Jesus' company. The temple in Jerusalem had been destroyed, and this was a sign for many that the end time was near and that Jesus would return. Only he didn't. And the community of beleaguered believers began to doubt and despair. Where was Jesus? Had he abandoned them? Had they got it wrong? Life was difficult, and memories of the one who brought life and hope were fading. It was in this context that John was inspired to write down his testimony in order to encourage and strengthen the believers. And today's text is part of what is known as the farewell discourse, where at the Last Supper, and fully knowing his days are numbered, Jesus gathers his followers around him to prepare them for what is to come. You remember he shocks them by kneeling and washing their feet and gives them a new commandment. Love one another just as I have loved you. He then reiterates who he is, the purpose of his earthly ministry, and what he's to do in the future, that he must leave his disciples but return to be with them in a different way, to be physically absent yet present, unseen yet evident. And in all this bewildering turmoil to come, the message to his followers is simply, love one another just as I have loved you. They who have my commandments and keep them are those who love me. And those who love me will be loved by my Father, and I will love them and reveal myself to them. The way of love that Jesus had demonstrated and called his disciples to was all-encompassing, unconditional and total. And those frightened, bewildered disciples must surely have wondered how on earth that would be possible without Jesus at their side to instruct and guide and encourage. All they could do was to hold on to his promise. When I'm gone, don't worry and don't be afraid, because I won't leave you alone. I'll ask the Father, and he'll send another advocate who will abide with you forever. The advocate, the promised spirit, sometimes translated as counselor, helper, comforter, companion, spirit of truth. The Holy Spirit is all of these. Jesus, the living Word, who was with God and was God, assured them that the same Spirit who dwells in him will abide and dwell in them also. And through the Spirit of truth, they will know he is with them, and when they live in his love and grace. In essence, Jesus is telling his followers that to know him is to know God, and to know God is to know love. Through Jesus, the Word made flesh, we learn that God's whole meaning is love. It was love that in Genesis swept over the face of the deep to create light and life. It was love, it was through love and for love that God breathed into humanity to give us life. It was love who, as the carol tells us, came down at Christmas. It was for love of humanity that Jesus died and opened the gates of heaven. God is love, John declares. His meaning is love, echoes Lady Julian. And with the knowledge of that love comes a huge challenge. For the disciples found, and Lady Julian found, and countless saints throughout the ages have found, that this gift of love, imbued by the Holy Spirit, isn't a feel-good experience to be held to oneself, or a secret to be shared by a small elite group. Abiding in Christ, and being in relationship with him, compels each of us to look outwards and to learn through his unconditional love for us to lead lives that are marked by love. And this for sure isn't easy. For we were called not only to love those who love us, those who share our faith, those who are like-minded, but also those who we wouldn't naturally warm to or want to become involved with, or prefer not to interact with. That sort of love is messy and difficult and costly, and therefore only possible through the gift of the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, helper and sustainer, who Jesus promised to his followers. In the church calendar, we're now moving from the season of Easter towards Ascension Tide and the dramatic outpouring of the Holy Spirit upon those believers who gathered together at Pentecost. May this be an opportunity for us to set time aside to sit in God's presence, to ponder afresh upon John's words, and allow our hearts and minds to be fully open and willing to abide in the love of the one who is the author of all love, and to pray for the Spirit of Truth to help, equip, sustain, and enable us, just as those disciples, just as Lady Julian, and countless faithful folk before us, to reach out with love to those we encounter as we journey onward through the many twists and turns of this earthly life. I end with Lady Julian's words. And so I saw fully that before ever God made us, he loved us. And this love was never quenched, nor ever shall be. And in this love he has done all his works. And in this love he has made all things profitable to us. And in this love our life is everlasting.
Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth,
of all that is seen and unseen.
We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Please sit or kneel for our prayers and intercession, which turn around before us.
Blessed be you, Lord our God, for you have created us all out of love, even when in our foolishness we go against you and go our own way, you seek us out in that love. Blessed are you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord Jesus, you say to us that if we love you, we will keep your commandments. Loving Jesus, our world seems full of temptation, especially to do things that are unwise and are not in keeping with your commandments. We do not always place you first. We put earthly wants and desires ahead of you. Loving Jesus, we ask that you strengthen our faith in these times of desire and inclinations, so that we will be able to receive your Spirit of truth. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Spirit of truth, may you work through your church throughout the world and show your love for all peoples and nations, and that they will recognise your good works. We bring to mind in our prayers the people of Ukraine as they continually live in fear because of the invasion by Russia. We also hold in our hearts the people of Sudan, caught between two warring factions, and all those places where there is conflict and unrest. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Merciful God, you say that you will not leave us orphans and that you will come back to us. We pray for everyone that has been affected by a man-made or natural disaster. We pray for all those who have lost loved ones and friends. We pray for the many orphanages and homeless children in our world. Children living on the streets or in makeshift shelters, trying to get by, surviving only on their nerves and wits. Lord Jesus, you have promised that you are coming back to us. Guide us also in going to help those who are feeling vulnerable, afraid and alone. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Compassionate God, as we hold your commandments in our heart, may we know and fear your loving presence about us. As we seek to share your love through our prayers to those who are suffering today, in mind, body, or spirit, we ask that love to be poured out, in particularly upon Simeon Patel and his family, James Bowman, Margaret Bowman, George Radcliffe, Audrey Clark, India Smith, Christina Wilkinson, Peter Wallison, Martin Harrison, and Ian. And all those who love and care for them. Let us also have a moment quiet as we pray for those who are known to us. We give thanks for the forgiveness of our ways and the hope of eternal life. We pray for our loved ones departed, and that we may all share in the glory of your presence and your love. We pray today for Joey Hedges, Francis Pike, and all those that are missing them. And we have another moment of silence as we remember our loved ones. Loving God, as we say farewell to Phil and Linda, we entrust them into your loving care. We pray for happiness and joy to be ahead of them, for wisdom and guidance to be beside them, and for grace and truth to be behind them, pushing them onwards into your goodness. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Would you please stand for the peace? Jesus came and stood among his disciples and said to them, "Peace be with you." Then were they glad when they saw the Lord. Alleluia. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace. Our offertory hymn number 445, God is here as we his people meet to offer praise and prayer. 445.
Thank you.
When we break bread, may we recognise you as the fire that burns within us, that we may bring light to your world. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Almighty and Eternal Father, and in these days of Easter to celebrate with joyful hearts the memory of your wonderful works. For by the mystery of his passion, Jesus Christ, your risen Son, has conquered the powers of death and hell, and restored in us the image of your glory. He has placed us once more in paradise and opened to us the gates of life eternal. And so with the joy of this Passover, earth and heaven resound with gladness, while angels and archangels and the powers of all creation sing forever the hymn of your glory. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Jesus Christ is Lord. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send your Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of St. Andrew and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord. By whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever. Amen. Rejoicing in God's new creation, let us pray with confidence, as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Jesus says, I am the bread of life. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. Lord, our hearts hunger for you. Give us this bread always. Thank you. May we thirst for you, the spring of life and source of goodness, through him who is alive and reigns, now and forever. Amen. Father of all, we give you thanks and praise that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, he declared your love, gave us grace, and opened the gates of glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We who use the Spirit guides give life to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name. Christ our Lord. Amen. I publish the banns of marriage between Tom Nicholas and Jordan Anna Jennifer Headley, both of this parish. This is the second time of asking. If any of you know any reason in law why they may not marry each other, you are to declare it. Pray for them. Dear Lord, we pray for Tom and Jordan. As we pray for them, so too we pray for Mia and Alfie. We pray for them as Tom and Jordan's wedding day draws closer, that you might draw them more deeply into their love for one another and for you. We ask your blessing on each of them and on their wider family. In your precious name we pray. Amen. I have written myself a little list. Doesn't the church look bare after there being an exhibition? Thank you so much again to everybody who had a hand in the last 10 days, in whatever way. It is not about numbers and it's not about money, but I thought nevertheless you might like to know. Well, we haven't counted the money, the donations, but here are the numbers. Not counting Sunday services or any other service, and not counting the food bank, through the door on our tally. Children, we had 216 children. I've got some lovely photos, which I need to double check I'm allowed to share, but of little children pointing at different things in the exhibition, finding little crowns that I've hidden around the place. They really, really loved it. Thank you very much indeed. 216 children, 300 adults, and 6 dogs who were edified by our efforts. There we go. Now, in chronological order, as we move through the week, Ascension Day is Thursday, and Sue is leading a quiet, reflective service in the evening at 7:15 on Thursday. Our usual 10 o'clock service will happen here in the chancel. Using, of course, the readings for Ascension Day. And in fact, on Monday, tomorrow, I'm taking a service in Millbrook House at 10:30, and we'll use the Ascension Day readings. So if you want to join in any of those services, please do 10:30 at Millbrook, 10 o'clock on Thursday here, and 7:15 on Ascension Day evening. Christian Aid, sorry, I've now jumped to my chronological order. The Christian Aid meal that Michelle gives away, Michelle, because not everyone will know who Michelle is, so Michelle is there, is organising. That's going to be a buffet supper, there is at least something to eat, because I can see that some of us have signed up already. There's a sign up for what you'd like to bring, but please come, even if you can't bring anything, just bring yourself, that would be great. And if you can bring a fiver, because that will go towards Christian Aid. If you want to bring a raffle prize as well, please do. Phil and Linda have emptied their wine cabinet. because they do better wine in Chesterfield, which will be about later. Anyway, so yes, bring anything, and it's
6:30 on the 27th of May, we'll have some posters very soon, and also tickets, 27th. And going backwards, the church and churchyard clear-up is Saturday, by which point the beds will look bare, because they are full of weeds. Church and churchyard clear-up on Saturday, 10:30 till 12. You do not need to have any gardening knowledge whatsoever, because the weeds are such that you'll be able to spot them. If you prefer to be inside, dusting, decobwebbing, all that kind of stuff, polishing. So clear-up next Saturday, the Saturday coming at 10:30 till 12. Everybody welcome. If you could bring your own tools and dusters, etc., that's helpful. Thank you. And now, should we do birthdays? Would anyone like to admit to having had a birthday? Not everybody enjoys admitting to having had a birthday. When is your birthday?
Friday.
Has it happened?
No, it's
Friday coming. That is a very nice causal link to my next thing. Linda's about to have a birthday on Friday. Anybody else wish to add to birthdays, past or present? There we are. Let's sing to Linda now. Thank you.
We pack and move on Tuesday. We complete on Wednesday. We are actually back in the area next weekend, but only on Saturday for an event featuring John Bell at the Cathedral. After that, who knows? Soon after this morning, checked with this morning that I'd done something last week, and I have to confess, I can't even remember what happened for breakfast this morning, let alone what happened 7 days ago. I can't even remember what I packed in the box half an hour ago. In town, we will miss so many people who are present here and others who we remember who have themselves moved on, although not spiritually. We have a little gift.
This is the wrong way around.
I don't think it is the wrong way around at all. Wrong way around. You need something to happen first.
On behalf of the church.
Right, on behalf of the church.
Would somebody else like to open on behalf of the church? That would be rather nice, wouldn't it? David's just been volunteered. This is splendid paper. This is dinosaur paper. There we are. No connection between dinosaur and the Church of England. There we go. And what's more, they're wearing woolly hats.
Just talk amongst yourselves.
This is typical of my new problem, I'm afraid.
Or my opening.
Do talk amongst yourselves.
Just trying to pat my party.
You cannot do it before Christmas, because it's good for front of paper. It's always fine. I do apologise.
We're in. Right, there you go. Take it from that.
It's going to be rather a disappointment, I'm afraid. At the end of it all.
I'm wondering if it's a mouse trap.
Well, it says here, plate holder is all display stand.
But of course, you can't have a plate or easel display stand unless you've got something to display it on. So, Ella, could you do the honors for that one?
Not comparing speed of ability to breaking practice. Hang on a minute, that's the place up there and see. My goodness me, now, hang on a minute. The mention of mice was because some of you may not be aware that over Easter, mice consumed a rather large quantity of the clergy's costumes, which everybody still has vestments in the cupboard. That's a good idea to remove them. Oh, look at this. Isn't this really lovely? It is a picture of the church. And it says on it, I'm going to have to stand still because I can't read it. That's
if you listen carefully, a few weeks ago, the last time I did the intercessions, I ended with this blessing, which is adapted from Aidan blessing the Holy Isle of Lindisfarne.
Here be the blessing. You read it, mate. Go on. We pray God's blessing on this place.
Here be the peace of those who do thy will. Here be the peace of one serving another. Here be the peace of holy folk obeying. Here be the peace of praise by dark and day. Be this place thy holy place. Be it thy care. Amen. And it simply is our prayer for St. Andrews. You and those who follow you and those who have been here over the years since it was first built.
Putting up with it. Philip Medley, you will be sorely, sorely missed. Let's pray God's blessing on that. Philip Medley, that the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you his peace. May he guide your ways, your next steps. In these days, months, and years to come. In your precious name, we pray. Amen.
And we will also need, in Eleanor's safekeeping, our new address. Some people know it already because we've been able to share it, but Eleanor, the responsibility rests lightly on your shoulders.
I trust their email addresses aren't changing, so right, I've got it. Good, thank you. Let's have this. Can somebody say, why don't you put that at the front door? Is that all right? How lovely. Splendid. Hang on a minute, and don't go away, because some people who are not me have been deeply away. Joy has been away making a cake, and we have a gluten-free alternative, which people are more than welcome to stay and share as we speed you on your way. And Harold has arranged for a gift. And there is a card, folks. If you have not already signed the card, it is, or at least was at the back. Not only has she arranged the gift, but she has arranged very fitting gift wrapping paper. There we are.
It's too pretty to unwrap. We'll take it with us.
Look at that, and a bag covered in flowers as well.
Yeah, it's beautiful. I'm
going to
try and get in.
I was thinking that Phil and Linda have been both upfront people and behind the scenes people. Thank you very much. We will miss you so much. We'll miss you for who you are. We'll also miss you for all you've done and been amongst us. Thank you so much. We had considered
flowers, but when you thought flowers were a bit of a pain when you're about to move house. We'd also considered gardening vouchers, but then there may not be a Scottsdale's in Chesterfield. So instead we got something to put the flowers in when they've grown them. And it has a little inscription. Better not forget.
That
would
be incredibly useful.
Hang on, someone wheeled that. There we go.
Thank you all very, very much for this. This is beautiful. Oh, that is beautiful.
Do you want to read it?
So Phil and Linda, thank you from all your friends in St Andrew's Church. So that's going pride place in my display cabinet. Thank you very, very much.
Right, while they wrap that up, we're going to sing our final hymn. Thank you so much. Please hang around for a coffee and cake if you can and have time. Our final hymn is 644, taking us back to the message of Julian Parish, God is Love, number 644. Would you please stand?
dead, our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the eternal covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and all whom you love, this day and forever. Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name